Did you want to write down anything, or we're just going to, since we're taping it?
Yeah, we can just.
So when I was a little boy, I remember Mom saying that your old dad was an alcoholic. And that he would come home and raise holy hell.
Is that a question, or?
Yeah.
Well,
is that the way it was, or?
Partially true. He was an alcoholic. Now, I don't recall him raising hell, but that's possible. See, I'm 4 years older, no, 2 years older than Doug. Yeah, 2 years older. And I remember everything that ever happened to me of any importance from the time I was 4 years old. So I would think that I'd know about that if it was true. And it may be. I do know he was an alcoholic, and that he and my mother had problems over that. But as far as him raising him, I don't recall that. Possible, I don't recall.
He died pretty young, I guess it was.
He died alcohol poisoning, and he died of emphysema, and he just, I think probably as much from malnutrition, and you know, drinking and drugs around probably.
How old was he?
40 some odd, I believe.
40 something?
Yeah, I've got it on my family tree. I can tell you exactly, but I think it was 48.
Wow.
He died. But
he left before that, right?
Oh yeah, he would go off on tricky business and leave us all there alone. But I don't know. I really don't know. I don't have any memory of doing anything like that referring. So I think what Dorothy is referring to is she may have heard some remarks by Daisy or some of the older ones, you know, that would know. And but I remember that.
She also told me that you and Pete and her beat up the whole school.
No, that's not true. She beat up the whole school. I'll tell you what, she was my bodyguard. I was a little skinny guy that they took on me, and Dorothy beat him up. I'll tell you, she'd say, well, one time, when we were going to this country school, you know, they had this one teacher and the whole grade together. And the teacher came up and whacked me on the hand because I'd done something. That's what they do with the ruler, you know?
Yeah.
And she hit me and Dorothy, and I screamed at her, you know. Dorothy jumped up and she whammed into that teacher. She said, no damn teacher's going to beat up my brother. I mean, she whipped her. Yeah, Mary got us all kicked out of school.
Yeah, I bet.
But she finally called down, but she really tied into that teacher. And that was her exact word. No damn teacher's going to beat up my brother.
That's hilarious. That's awesome.
But she looked after me because I was kind of a skinny little runt.
Yeah.
But it took my place.
She said she also lived with Ladella for a while.
Yeah, she did. When we moved out to the country, Jake had got a little pension from the government, and we bought a farm out there and moved out on the postal. And of course, we had nothing to make a living with, and the farm was no good. And Dorothy, I don't know. I'll look back on it. I think that Jake was kind of getting out of line, that's right. And so Mama called Ella, and she came out and got her. And she lived with Ella several months, I don't know how long exactly, but she entered school in New Franklin, so she lived with her for maybe up to a year. And now why she left and came back, I don't exactly remember, but she did. Yeah, she lived with Ella for almost a year. I think probably it was to get her out of the house. You know, I'm not sure. Did she mention that?
Not the part about Jake. Just that. Actually, I didn't have a good picture of when Jake came into the equation.
Well, Jake came in before we moved to the farm. And see, my dad died in 31, and Mom and Jake married shortly after that. So,
Grace never divorced. Your dad's name
James.
Was James Harmon.
James Harmon.
Yeah. She never divorced James Harmon. Separated by death.
They were divorced.
No, they did get a divorce.
They got divorced, and they were divorced several months, probably a year before he died. And because he came back, and he lived with Daisy, my dad, for a while. And then they ended up in the hospital in Bloomville with Dr. Ravensway. Dr. Ravensway was doctor who was kind of ahead of his time, and he not only was a family doctor, but he was a surgeon, and he operated on my dad, and I think that's all on his death, because he really wasn't qualified for that kind of surgery. And he moved parts of his lungs, and his so,
what were some of the jobs that Grandma had? Do you remember any?
Some of the what?
Any jobs that she had?
Jobs?
Jobs.
Jobs?
Yeah.
Oh. Before my mother and dad ever separated, we moved around a lot, and Mama would work for household duties, you know, for different people, pick and wash, and anything to make money.
Mm-hmm.
And we also, you know, jobs were hard to find back in those days. And my dad kind of went from one, kind of like these fruit, what do you call them, these people?
The fruit stands or something?
Travel from one job to the other, picking fruit or
jobs.
And we'd go down into Arkansas, and we went to cotton fields, and all of them, my mother, and all except me and Dorothy and Pete were involved in picking them together, but we were too young. But I remember they had picked cotton and other crops, and like in Atkins, Arkansas, that's where Pete was born. We went down there to pick pickles, cucumbers. Atkins is a big pickle place, you know. Atkins still pickles that you buy today. They're made in Atkins.
Huh.
And my family, mom and dad, and my sister, would pick those cucumbers and get paid for picking. So that's why we made a living. And the next thing we do, we travel from there to Arkansas and pick strawberries. And the whole family was involved, except us three younger ones. We'd just be along for the ride. That's how we ended up in Billings, Missouri. We came from Arkansas up to Billings, Missouri. And that's where Allie and my little sister died of appendicitis.
Oh, appendicitis. Yeah, that was another question that we had for you. Is how did she? How did she pass away? How old was she?
She was seven.
Seven? Wow.
And it's a few months. But she had appendicitis, and I remember we were traveling in a covered wagon. And I could hear her moaning and crying from pain because appendicitis was very painful. And we came to Billings, I didn't know what to do. So we started out headed for Springfield, ended up at Cox Hospital, and that's where she died. And she was entered in the hospital and her appendix burst. Peritonitis set in. And that was before penicillin and all that kind of stuff. So the poison just overwhelmed her. That's what happened.
Where were you, younger than her, or were you older than her?
Which one, Allie?
Yeah, Allie.
I was younger than Allie.
Okay.
Allie was seven something, so I was still four something. And see, there's 2 years almost between every one of them except Allie and I, and we had a girl. Grown for 2 years apart.
Wow.
And when Allie was born, she was out of that line because Georgie was born then, and Allie was born next after Georgie. So when she died, then that may be next in line from Georgie to me, and then Dorothy and Pete. But Allie was a beautiful little girl. I remember her playing with her. I remember the agony she suffered with her appendicitis.
Yeah, four. Yeah, that's an impressive memory.
Yeah.
How did Paul, Grandpa, and Dorothy meet? You remember?
You know, I don't know exactly. I know that I was working at Freddy's. Dorothy had come back to Mom's. And I went to Dallas. Went to work for Freddy's. During that time, they met, and I don't know exactly where. Except I know that it just seemed like Paul and Dorothy had been together forever. You know? And
I think they met at the shoe factory.
I think they did.
Yeah.
I don't know. I can't. That's one thing that escapes me. Because I was working down at Freddy's and I was pretty much isolated down there from the family for a while.
What's Freddy's? Freddy's. What's Freddy's?
Snotty store.
Della. Ladella and Freddy Snotty had a store at.
Was it Ladella with your sister?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So he was my brother-in-law.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
And that's where Dorothy had stayed for the temporary event, and I went down there and went to work for him in the store and lived with Ladella and Freddy.
How did you and Lorraine meet?
Well, Lorraine, you know, she was married to Luke. It was a miscarriage from the word go. And
might be something like that.
She they separated. And I just fell in love with Lorraine the minute I saw her from day one. But I knew she married a book, you know, I stayed out at night. I had nothing to do.
Yeah.
And I went off to war. When I came back, or they were separated and divorced. So then I started going there.
Who's Buki? Like, how did
James?
Who was Buki?
Buki was my nephew. It was one of Daisy's. It was Billy's brother. You know, Billy and Buki.
Oh, okay.
And Daisy was their mother.
Oh, okay.
And sister.
Okay.
And his
English, Robert.
Everybody called him Boogie? Huh. And how long did you guys date before you got married?
Good 3 years.
Yeah.
I had always said, you know, before I went overseas, I was going with Hilda in front of me. And she wondered, when I went to the Army, she wanted to join the ranks. And I said, no, no way you can be with me. She said, well, she did something. So she wanted to get married. And I said, no, I won't marry anybody until I come back from overseas, make sure I'm going to be alive. I'm going to leave some widow and possibly an orphan. So, next thing I heard, she enlisted in the Navy and ended up marrying an admiral.
Wow.
So, and I saw her after the war was over, and she had done very well for herself. So, but anyway, I started going with Helene.
No.
Here. Well, that's probably not a good idea. Here, can you have one of those balls, that blue ball?
Just working, Dad.
Give him that.
Can you play with this, James?
What?
So it's like a stress ball.
Stress ball?
Yeah, sure.
He'll throw that around.
Yeah.
Was Dorothy ever baptized? Were you guys baptized?
I'm sure she was, but I don't recall because. I was not baptized until after I don't think so.
I remember.
I'm sure she was baptized, but I don't know when.
Yeah. Yeah, she told me one time that she was baptized. But it was probably when I was real little or before I was born.
Yeah, I think it was after she was married. Maybe Paul,
same. Yeah. Dad found some videos of all of us on the lake. It was Dorothy and Paul and Jimmy and Leela and Ronnie and Debbie and Aaron and Stacy and Lindsay and me and Mom and Dad. And it was so nice to see everybody on the boat, and I was water skiing, and Lindsay was water skiing, and then Uncle Jimmy was taking everybody out on the, on the lake, trying to throw everybody off the inner tube. And,
yeah.
I had some great memories down at your guys' little camper with Kelly.
Uh-huh.
We loved going down there, getting that little separate camper all set up just for Kelly and I, playing, playing house in there. Oh my gosh, we just loved it. And your all's lot back there was so quiet and nestled in, and it was off the road a little bit of ways, wasn't it?
Well, it backed up to the motel, and we had a fence between us and the motel, and it was really kind of an isolated area back there.
Yeah.
And the street running right in front of ours, so we had a nice quiet.
Yeah, you guys had a nice lot.
And I do remember you and Kelly playing in the camper.
Oh yeah.
Had great times.
Loved it, yeah.
And Mimi was she was really special towards you kids. She helped you in kind of set up housekeeping and
everything. Oh, she loved it too, yeah. She absolutely loved it. Yeah. I think I remember her bringing us some snacks every now and again, and she'd come up there, help us get everything set up.
We set up a little dinner.
Oh, it was so much fun.
Yeah, she was great at that.
He's hitting you, isn't he? Yeah, some of my best moments of my life were down there at Pomme de Terre.
Yeah.
Such good times. I just told Dad the other day, I'm like, I would love to live on the lake. There's something special about a lake, for sure.
Yeah, there is. Well, we lived there for a number of years after I retired.
Mm-hmm.
I sure enjoyed it. It was fun.